Tesla CEO Elon Musk announced in 2015 that the electric vehicle company would enter the energy business, and now he's starting to get up. In its Q4 2020 earnings call, the company said battery deliveries increased 83% in 2020 thanks to the popularity of Megapack, which stores energy specifically for utilities. Isn't it something unique and exciting? Do you know Tesla is taking over the world with energy farms? If you didn't know that, or you knew it but want to know more about it, then stay with us till the end of the video. Solar and renewable energy, such as wind, need battery storage for when the wind is not blowing and the sun is not shining. Demand for these large-scale storage systems is growing as countries worldwide set targets for the transition to renewable sources. According to Grandview Research, grid-scale battery storage is expected to be a $15 billion market by 2027. CNBC visited PG&E's Tesla Megapack site in Moss Landing, California, and learned why energy storage systems like Tesla's could be ambiguous in the future of renewable energy. Tesla's primary source of income comes from the sale of its electric vehicles, but its latest quarterly earnings report showed growth in its energy storage and solar energy business. According to Tesla CEO Elon Musk, the demand picture will become even brighter for the division if the company can access enough chips for its energy storage products. Tesla reported $801 million in revenue from its power generation and storage business, which includes three main products: solar power, its Powerwall storage device for homes and businesses, and its unit utility storage Megapack. And that's only a fraction of the nearly $12 billion in total. Small as it is, the division sells more energy and solar storage. This division's revenue increased 62% from the previous quarter and over 116% from the same quarter in 2020. Tesla does not separate income from solar power and energy storage. More importantly, the cost of revenue from its solar and energy storage business was $781 million. Which means that for the first time, the total cost of producing and distributing these storage products was less than the income generated. It's good news. As you might expect, total deployments have also increased. Tesla installed 1,274 megawatt hours of energy storage in the second quarter of 2021, rising 205% over the same period last year. Likewise, the amount of solar power deployed in the second quarter of this year was 85 megawatt hours, up 214% from the second quarter of 2020. The big nugget is revenue growth. In 2019, Tesla reported $369 million in revenue from solar power and storage. Income stagnated in the second quarter of 2020, with $370 million coming from this activity. This quarter was more than double what Tesla contributed in the same quarter of 2019 and 2020. What has changed? In addition to COVID-19, Tesla highlights the launch of several Megapack projects and the growing popularity of its combined solar and Powerwall products. Tesla no longer allows customers to order Powerwall without a solar installation. According to a configurator on Tesla's website, a Megapack costs around $1.2 million before taxes. In some states, Tesla says the first deliveries will take place in 2023. However, Tesla's energy storage business faces headwinds. Musk said, "Demand for the Powerpack and Powerwall is exceeding supply and a backlog is growing. The company is unable to meet this demand due to the global chip shortage," he said. Tesla uses the same chips in its Powerwall as it does in its vehicles, and Musk has said, "Vehicles are the priority while supply is low. As this significant shortage is alleviated, we can massively ramp up Powerwall's production," Musk said on an earnings conference call. "I think we have a chance of achieving an annualized rate of 1 million units of Powerwall next year, maybe in the range of 20,000 per week, again depending on the supply of cells and semiconductors. As the world shifts to sustainable power generation, solar and wind are intermittent, and by their nature, really need batteries to provide a constant flow of electricity. And when you look at all the utilities around the world, a lot of backup batteries are needed." Musk said that in the long run, Tesla and other suppliers would need to produce 1,000 to 2,000 gigawatt hours per year in order to meet energy storage demands. Musk said the company has asked its cell suppliers to double their supply in 2022, a target that Musk said would depend on supply chain issues. The company's current strategy is to move beyond self-supply and route it to its energy storage products. But as with chip shortages, vehicle production would be prioritized, according to Musk. While much of the discussion about battery cells has focused on its 4680 cells under development, Musk also touched on Tesla's intentions to power some of its products with lithium iron phosphate batteries, less expensive. Specifically, he said there is a good chance that all stationary storage could be moved to iron-based batteries and away from nickel, manganese, cobalt, and nickel, cobalt, aluminium batteries. If you have gotten this far, be sure to smash the subscribe button for more awesome content. I think we'll probably see a change. I guess it would probably be 2/3 iron, 1/3 nickel, Musk said of Tesla's plans. And that's really good because there's quite a bit of iron in the world, an insane amount of iron. But there is much less nickel and there is much less cobalt. 1/3 of the batteries that will remain nickel-based will be used for their longer-range electric vehicles. All of its other electric cars would also switch to LFP batteries, which is already happening in its vehicles assembled in China. This growth results from significant improvements in Tesla's solar modernization strategy, including product simplification, cost reduction, and industry-leading pricing. This is probably just the start of the boom ahead for Tesla's electricity business. The company has long said it wants to be one of the world's largest electric or utility companies, and global capital is mobilizing resources to encourage the switch to renewables. Tesla could be a huge beneficiary of the Biden administration's renewable energy plans, thanks to their goals to significantly boost solar development and buildings. Big infrastructure spending will require big batteries to store renewable energy, and it will also require massive solar installations. You may enjoy this video here. Until next time, thank you for watching.